I remember the first day he walked in through the, he had to bend down coming through the door. I went, and when he stood up to his full height, I remember thinking, that's absolutely phenomenal. I've never seen anything like it in my life.
You know, everybody rallied around him. We just loved him. I mean, he was so smart and so gentle and sweet.
He was just a giant of a human being in every imaginable way, but particularly in the way of his heart.
I remember he used to put his hand on my head, and when we'd be outside, and it was freezing cold where we were, and it would come down to here. His fingers would come here, and it would cover the back of my neck. His hand was so big, and it would keep me warm.
I remember making a point of shaking hands with him every day, just to have the sensation of your hand disappearing into this mitt. His hand was this big.
And action.
Some people think wrestling is acting, instead of making a movie. When you're in the ring, you're on your own. If you do something wrong, they don't go to say, cut and do it again.
His acting instincts, because he had never done it before, and because he was a natural actor from being in, you know, in the wrestling ring, they were always pure. He never made false moves. He would do things that were totally natural. I mean, you never had to tell him, I mean, physically stuff, you know, to pick up a guy's head or to move him around. He always did the right things.
That's enough! That's enough!
My children, when they found out I was doing the movie with a giant, and they said, a giant? You're working with a giant, Daddy? Really, Daddy? You're working with a giant? How big is the giant, Daddy? Is he as big as a house? Is he as big as a car? Is he as big as the doorway over there? Can he get through the door when he went? I mean, literally, they could not stop talking about Andre. So by the time they came to England, they were so sort of quivering to see Andre. So I brought them to the set one day, and of course they're just like gaga, ready to go, nuts. And Andre was in a very long, very large trailer. And we walk up the steps, and we turn the corner, and Andre gets up. And as soon as he gets up, my three-year-old looked at him and went,
there will be no survivor.
Beat it, or I'll call the brute squad.
I'm on the brute squad. I'm the brute squad.
And Rob is, you know, in the editing room. Rob knows the lines. I am the brute squad.
I'm on the brute squad.
You are the brute squad.
I loved Andre. He had this farm in North Carolina, as I recall, and he said he loved walking with the animals because they don't look twice at him. And he said, big people, little people, we get gypped.
It's difficult everywhere I go because they don't build anything for big people. They build everything for blind people, for crippled people, for some other people, but not for big people. So we have to fit in there. And it's not too easy all the time.
Andre had difficulty bearing weight because of his back problems. So they hired a giant where they knew he couldn't speak English, but they figured at least they won't have trouble with any of the giant stuff. And he actually handled the English language fine and couldn't lift a feather.
He couldn't even hold me. I had to be hooked up to cables when I'm supposed to fall into his arms. And, you know, 100 pounds, he couldn't, it killed him.
My favorite moment with him, Andre and I were on the boat alone with only the script supervisor.
Hello.
She turned to Andre and she said, have you enjoyed this experience? Has it been enjoyable for you? Has it been pleasurable for you? And he said, oh, yes. She said, tell me how, what have you enjoyed about it? He looked at her and he said, without skipping a beat, nobody looks at me. There you had it. He was just one of the guys.
So Andre, tell us what it's been like for you doing this movie. Been a rotten experience, or has it been fun?